finishing up strong here. Problem numero 4. It says tungsten, W, a metal used in light bulb filaments, is produced industrially by the reaction of tungsten oxide with hydrogen. Light bulb. So excited to solve this problem. We're given an equation that's already balanced. Yes! How many liters of hydrogen gas at 35 degrees Celsius and 0.980 atmospheres are needed to react completely with 875 grams of tungsten oxide? Ooh! Okay, so this is definitely your most complex gas stoichiometry problem that you're going to see. You have to combine not only your understanding of stoichiometry with the ideal gas law. So the first thing I'm going to do is start with my 875 grams of tungsten oxide, or WO3. And I'm going to convert that to moles of tungsten oxide. Tungsten, where are you? From the periodic table, the molar mass of tungsten oxide is 232 grams. I'm going to then convert my moles of tungsten oxide to moles of hydrogen gas needed to react with it. This relationship comes from the balanced chemical equation. 3 moles of hydrogen gas will react with 1 mole of tungsten oxide. A quick trip to my calculator.
875 times 1 divided by 202 times 3 divided by 1.
I'm going to need 11.3 moles of hydrogen gas. Now, what's tricky about this problem is that we're asked for liters of hydrogen, but we're not at STP. Pivnert! So now I'm going to use the ideal gas law to solve for the volume based on the temperature and pressure conditions that I'm provided with in the problem. I'm first going to rearrange this equation to solve for volume. To do that, I need to divide each side by pressure. So the ideal gas law solve for volume is equal to nRT over P. All right, so I'm just going to plug in my numbers to this rearranged gas law, ideal gas law equation. My number of moles is 11.3, solved using stoichiometry. The ideal gas law, 0.0821 atmospheres times liters per mole Kelvin from the formula chart, times my temperature, 298 Kelvin. Now, if you're wondering how I got 298 Kelvin, recognize that in the problem, I'm given 35 degrees Celsius. And we can convert this to Kelvin by simply adding 273, which will give us 298 Kelvin. The pressure in atmospheres is 0.980, which is why I chose the 0.0821 R value, because my pressure units will cancel out. A quick trip to my calculator. Indicates that I'm going to make 282 liters of hydrogen gas. And that is the most difficult type of problem you can expect to see on this next test.